and welcome to Living Waters Christian Center for Kids, our very first service. It's so good to have you with us. Now, if you're a mountain mover or a little trooper, I just want to say we miss you guys so much and we're thinking of you and sending you lots of prayers and hugs during this time. Today, we're going to watch a video about faith and overcoming fear, and it's by Sean Bowles. So let's jump straight in, guys.
Hey, you guys, I wanted to make a video for you because I remember walking through some things when I was your age, and I was a Christian at all ages because I got saved when I was three, and how God walked with me. And I want to share some of those things about when I walked through hard times, like what our world is going through right now. There's a lot of fear. Some of you are curious about the virus, what it could do. Some of you are worried about your parents' finances or things that are happening in the economy. I want to encourage you that God is so good and he helps us so much. And one of the things that he's done, it says in Timothy, is that he's given us not a spirit of fear, but of power and love and a sound mind. And sometimes we can have cyclical thoughts that go through our head over and over of fear or anxiety where we just go, oh my gosh, there's different types of fear. One of the types of fear is like, I'm so afraid. And we have a panic, you know, and we go, what do I do with this panic? What do I do with this panic? And we have the thought go through over and over and over. One of them is a kind of a low, kind of deep down anxiety where just I can't enjoy life right now because I feel every time I have a quiet space or I'm not playing a game or I'm not talking to someone, I can feel like anxiety or I feel, you know, my heart is not doing good in this area. And that's an anxiety fear. There could be just absolute shocking fear, like you hear bad news about something and it just makes you so sad, or it makes you so afraid or so alone. And all of those types of things are normal for kids to experience, but you don't want to stay there. It's of course okay to experience fear. We all experience a human emotion like that, but we don't want to stay there. And the gospel or the Bible helps us to overcome fear in our relationship with God. Joshua 1:9, did you know that God told Joshua, I've commanded you to be strong and of good courage. Now, God would never tell someone, you have to be strong and you have to be courageous if he doesn't give you the power to be that or the power to do that. God's so good. So he's commanded us to be strong and have good courage. That means that when we face fear, we have to face it. We don't just entertain it. We face it. And when we face fear, there's a couple things you could do. When fear hits you the first time, when you first initially experience fear, if it's like something really scary happens, maybe it's a fear from a night dream or a night terror, maybe it's something you've heard from somebody, maybe somebody you know is getting sick. The first time you experience fear, surrender it to God. Say, God, I give you fear and I exchange my fear for your faith. And it may not be that you feel differently right away, but you're giving Holy Spirit room to move. He's so good at building faith in you. He's so good at taking your thoughts of fear and making them feel so small compared to his great big faith he has for you. And did you know that the place that faith occupies, that's the place that fear wants to live? And we don't want to give fear any place to live there because then our faith doesn't grow. So we want to allow God to have our fear.
Okay.
The second thing is there's a lot of practices you could do with God. One of them is a type of praying or meditation, which means, and meditation is a good word, not a bad word. It means whenever you think something negative in your head and it keeps going through, like, I'm afraid, I'm afraid, I'm afraid. It could be like a monster in the bed type thing, or it could be a sickness, or it could be financial failure for your parents or whatever, you know, thinking, what if this happens, which aren't true at all. None of these things are true. You're not going to get sick and die. This isn't God's story for you. And you're not going to have, your parents are going to be okay financially. And you're not going to have a monster appear in your room. That's not God's will for you. And so whenever you have these fears that feel irrational fears, and whenever you have those and it comes over and over and over, as you stop the thoughts by thinking about Jesus. Now, there's a number of ways to do this. One is you can think of your favorite worship song.
Jesus is a friend of mine.
Jesus is my friend.
Jesus is a friend of mine.
I have a friend in Jesus.
But sometimes you think of your favorite worship song and it doesn't help that fear go away. So you start to think about Jesus and Bible stories. And if that doesn't make it go away, start to think about your favorite things in life. Because when you're thinking about your favorite things in life, those all come from God, right? Every good thing comes from God. So if you're thinking negative thoughts over and over and over, or fear thoughts over and over and over, stop the cycle by thinking and meditating on what's good. So start to think of your last birthday and what you loved about it. Think about a trip that you went on with your family and rehearse all the details that you love the best. Think about, like, as if you're telling it as a story to a friend, and just go over and over in your mind what you love the most about that. And then start dreaming about the future, future trips you're going to go on, future birthdays, future good things. If you're in sports, future times you're going to win, and dream and imagine those kinds of things. The Bible says in Ephesians 3:20 that God's going to do what beyond what you can hope for or imagine in your wildest dreams. And so this is one of the ways that we can overcome fear, is that we can train our own minds to think good thoughts. Now, another thing we can do is, if you face fear and you can't get over it by practicing, focusing on the good, as far as in good past experiences or good future experiences, think about the good things that God's done in your life. Have you been sick before and he healed you? Or have you been sick and your body overcame it because it gave you the immune system to overcome it? Or has someone in your family had a time where they faced something that was really hard and you watched them pull through? Remember those times when you're stressed out or when there's anxiety. Or if you're in your room at night and you're all afraid and thinking, oh my gosh, something's going to creep around the corner, then start to think about, is my God smaller than that or bigger than that? And also, are my parents smaller than that or bigger than that? Has there ever been a time that I've been attacked by somebody or a monster's come or these kinds of things have happened? Probably not. And so think about the fact that this is probably the enemy trying to put irrational fear inside of you that's completely at war with the nature of God, that God loves you so much that he's given you, like I said, a spirit of power. That means you have more power than the enemy. No matter what age you are watching this, he's given you self-discipline or the ability to think really clear thoughts that are good, and also a sound mind, which means you won't have those thoughts that cycle like a circle in your head over and over and over. You can prevent those things by walking with God. And I want to give you some tools. Now, remember, every time you get sick at all or feel sickness on your body, don't go to the worst case scenario, like I'm going to die. Think about the fact that God made your body to live. So he's given you an incredible immune system. And so you can eat healthy foods and make healthy choices for exercise. And you could do the natural, but you could also in the spirit pray and say, God, let my body work exactly how you intended it at this age of my life. Don't let my body get sick. And if you start to struggle with something, because some of you might have something like an asthma or diabetes or something like that, that doesn't have to be your story. Because when God first created you, he created you to be perfectly made in your body. And that means that if there's something in your body now that wasn't part of God's original intention, you can pray to God and ask him to give strategy, both physically, naturally, through medical, but also spiritually, to bring healing. And you're allowed to ask him for that. Anything that would hinder you from doing everything that God created you for, God wants to take out of your body and take out of your fear and take out of your mind and take out of your heart. So I want to tell you that God's with you. He's really going to strengthen you in this time. And I want to encourage you to read good books and good stories, play good video games. Don't play things that are dark. Don't read things that are dark. Don't read things that have a lot of lack of hope in them. Read victorious things that make you have hope. God, I pray that everyone who's watching us, that you would give us so much courage, and that we would reject fear, that we'd reject any kind of sickness, God, that our bodies wouldn't even take sickness on at all, and that our minds and our hearts and our emotions would reject fear. We know that fear is not your story or your truth for us. So God, tell your story to our emotions, tell your story to our spirit, tell your story to our heart. And we just stand on the Bible and we stand with you, Holy Spirit. Would you help us in this time? And thank you that you've given us your spirit of power and love and a sound mind. And you've commanded us to be courageous. And we receive that right now in Jesus' name. And we want to be strong for the people in our family as well. So help us, God, when they have fear, to help pray for them too. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm praying for you guys. I love you.
How great is Sean, guys? Now I'm just going to do a little experiment with you guys, just to explain how when we have fear in our life, it bottles us all up, but when we have Jesus in our lives, it completely eradicates it all and we have no room for fear. Okay guys, so I have just an old plate or something, just because it's going to make a little bit of mess, in an old cup, some bicarb soda, and just some white vinegar. All right, so this cup represents you. We're empty and we're spotless and we're blameless, just how God made us. But when fear comes into our lives, it starts to fill us up, whether it's bullies that we're scared of, or the COVID-19, or our parents' finances, like Sean said, or anything else that we're afraid of, starts to fill us up with fear. And we can't get rid of that fear, and it starts to fill up more and more and more, just like it has in this cup. But when we have Jesus, he washes us completely clean. So Jesus is like the vinegar in this case. So when we pray to God and we ask him for his help when we're afraid, he comes into our lives and gets rid of all the fear. It can't stay anymore. And it gets rid of all our fear. But as you can see, there's still a little bit in here. So when we praise the more or make room for God, if we surrender our fears to Him, He will always come in and get rid of all of our fears and our anxieties. How cool is that? And it's still going. And as you can see, there's nothing left, only God. So that's like our fear. When we surrender everything to God, there's no room for anything else but Jesus. How cool is that, Science Hits Moment, guys? I absolutely love that if we have fear, that God completely pushes it out and leaves nothing left, only Him. Now, the next thing is just a little craft, but I'm going to just leave the PDF there for you guys to do and print off if you want to. But it's just a little fear chatterbox that has some really cute animal pictures and some quotes and some really cool Bible verses about overcoming fear. Now, that's really all from me, guys, but I do want to ask you the question and get you guys to write it down in the comments below or on Messenger, whatever you like, that what worries you guys the most? Now, I really want to encourage you guys and just really connect with you guys around this, because it's so important that we're not afraid during this time, because God says, "Fear not, for I am with you." And that really is just a last commandment, guys, that we're not to be afraid. Now, the last thing I want to do, and I'll say goodbye, is just to finish with a song that I really love. And when I'm afraid, I can listen to this song and it'll just remind me of God's presence, that He is with me and that He will never forsake me and that I'm not to be afraid. So that's all from me, guys. Have a great week.